Good morning friends, welcome to today's class and today we are going to see the another important topic in 5th unit, inductive learning. In the last class we have seen learning from observation. In that class we have seen what is learning, that is the learning agent and the components of learning agent. After that we have seen the different types of learning, that is supervised learning, unsupervised learning and reinforcement learning. All those things we have seen in the last class, and today we are going to see the inductive learning. Next we will move to the need of inductive learning, and there are basically two methods of knowledge extraction. First one is by using the domain expert and second one is by using the machine learning. Here if the data is very large amount, then the domain expert are not useful and reliable. So we will move to machine learning approach. That is, if the data volume is very huge, then machine learning is very good and it will give some reliable result. First we should understand what is inductive learning. It is otherwise called as deterministic supervised learning. Now we can understand, isn't it, what is supervised learning. Here first the input. The input is verified and error free input which is given to a function f. Then the output will be f of x. After that we can give the another set of inputs which are not verified, that is raw inputs, to the same function f, and then verify the output f of x. So by using all the f of x, that is the outputs, we should generate the rules. So this is called as inductive learning. And now we will see the definition of inductive learning. The inductive learning is also known as discovery learning. It is a process where the learner discovers rules by observing the examples. So how we are going to discover the rules? By observing different examples we can discover the rule. We can often work out a rule for ourselves by observing the example. If there is a pattern, then record it. Pattern is otherwise called as rules here. Then we apply the rule in different situation to see if it works or not. With inductive language learning, tasks are designed specifically to guide the learner and assist them in discovering the rule. Therefore, inductive learning is the system tries to make a general rule from a set of observed instances. Here the observed instances are the examples, and the system is nothing but an algorithm, that is our function, and the general rule is the output from this function. And we will see some example for here. First I will take mango and I am going to apply this input, mango input, to the function, then the output will be sweet. This is our first example, example 1. We are going to use the same function for different input, that is banana. Now my new input is banana. I am giving the same input to the function. The next the output will be sweet. And the third example is apple. I am going to apply the apple for the same function, then the output will be sweet. So by using all these things I can generate my rule, that is all fruits are sweet. This is my general rule. And next to the supervised learning, the learning algorithm is given the correct value of function. So initially we have to give only the correct values, that is the correct input, to the function, then the output will be a verified output. Then we can change the representation of the function to try match information provided by the feedback. That is, we are going to give the different inputs to the same function, and we will record the output and verify that output by using the feedback. Feedback is nothing but the verified output which are already recorded in our system. So this is called as supervised learning. To understand inductive learning, we will see another example. Here we are having a set of examples having the attributes. So these are all set of examples which are having the attributes place, type, weather, location and decisions. So these are the attributes, and we are having 7 different examples. So these are all examples. So our task is to generate a set of rules, under what condition and what is the decisions. This is our task. So here our entire example is divided into two based on the decision. In this attribute we will take decision as the primary attribute, and based on the decision value we can split the entire data into two subsets. First one is subset 1 and subset 2. In subset 1 decision is yes and subset 2 decision is no. And next we will take the weather attribute. In the weather attribute we can say if it is warm then decision is yes, windy, all windy may be no, and warm and winter then the decision will be yes. And next we will take the location. If the location is Shimla then the decision is yes, if the location is Mumbai then decision is no, and if the location is Kulu then the decision may be yes. And next we will go to place type. Here the location is hilly then the decision is yes. For all the other place type the decision will be either no or yes is coming, but only the hilly then the decision is yes. So based on this the iteration will be repeated and finally we will generate the rules. So in the first iteration we will take the weather column. And then we can generate the rule, if weather is warm then decision is yes. And the second iteration we can take the place type. If the place type is hilly then decision is yes. And third iteration we can take the location. If the location is Shimla then the decision is yes. And fourth iteration we can take location again. If the location is Mumbai then the decision is no. In the fifth iteration we can take both place type and weather. And if the place type is beach and weather is windy then the decision is no. Likewise we can generate all the rules and finally we get the rule set. Here we are having five rules which are generated from the given data set. And now we will see our textbook example. The example is a pair of x comma f of x. X is the input and f of x is the function applied on that x and that gives an output. The task of pure inductive inference or induction is that given a collection of examples of f which returns the function h that approximates f where the function h is called hypothesis, a good hypothesis will generalize well, that is that will predict unseen examples correctly. So this is the fundamental problem of induction. First, fitting a function of single variable to be some data points. For example, we can take a straight line function f of x equal to mx plus c. Here we are taking only single variable x and f of x will be the formula of a straight line. Here both x and f of x are real numbers. After that we have to choose the hypothesis space H which are called as set of hypotheses, that is used to consider to be the set of polynomial degree at most k. Here we need to generate a polynomial functions that is not a straight line functions. So we are going to apply the both straight line function and polynomial functions to a set of examples. And these are the example diagram for x comma f of x bar. The first diagram is for linear hypothesis. Here all the data set will be exactly fit into the linear hypothesis function. So these are the given data sets. And in the diagram B, all the data are exactly fit into degree 7 polynomial hypothesis for the same set of data. And in the diagram 3 we are having different functions. First one is the linear hypothesis function and second one is degree 6 polynomial fit. Here the degree 6 polynomial fit is exact but the hypothesis is, that is the linear hypothesis is approximate. Most of the input are not fit into the linear hypothesis function. And the fourth diagram, this is exactly fit for the sinusoidal fit for the same data set. So the hypothesis function is a sinusoidal hypothesis function. There is a trade-off between expressiveness of hypothesis space and the complexity of finding simple consistent hypothesis within that space. For example, fitting straight line to the data is very easy and fitting high degree polynomial is harder, but fitting into Turing machine is very hard because determining whether a given Turing machine is consistent or not. And prefer a simple hypothesis spaces in which the resulting hypothesis may be simpler to use and it is faster to compute h of x when h is linear function than when it is an arbitrary Turing machine program. Students, up to this we have seen what is inductive learning and we have seen some examples for this also. And now this is the question time. And I asked only one question here, define inductive learning, and you just write the answer in the comment box. Thank you all of you.